Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 13.3.1 Developer Beta 1. This is a little bit unexpected, as many of us expected this to just release to the public with a few minor fixes, and instead they've pushed it out as a beta. So this is available to developers and soon to public beta testers. If you're not seeing the public beta by now, it'll be out later today or the following day. Now this came in at 3.95 gigabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. Depending on the device that we have here, such as my iPhone XR, it came in closer to 3 gigabytes. Anytime you go from a public version to a beta or from a beta back to a public version, it's a very large size, and then the normal updates are just smaller. Now let's take a look at the build number. The build number is 17D5026C. And this particular build does not have a whole lot in it that you can see physically. In fact, Apple's notes have nothing in them whatsoever. And unfortunately, their notes just keep getting worse and worse. They used to have a lot of things such as known issues and bug fixes and all sorts of things. And they've just not updated it lately. So hopefully we'll see an update. If you have the beta and you want to look at the notes, you can see it under the feedback app. But unfortunately, there's just nothing there. However, there are a couple things to note. The first thing is there is a modem update, and on my 11 Pro Max, it seems to help significantly. In fact, I installed the update, went outside, and immediately once I went off Wi-Fi, I connected to cellular, no problem whatsoever. I've never had it connect that fast since probably iOS 13.3 or maybe iOS 12 on a different phone. So it's definitely seeming to be fixed as far as that goes. And I noticed apps grabbing onto data much quicker. So things like YouTube or YouTube Studio, when I go into YouTube, it just seemed to load much quicker as far as pulling the data that I needed. So that's a really great thing. Now, another thing I noticed is storage size. I actually checked my storage before I installed the update and then after. So let me show you that. Here's a screenshot before I installed the update. 47.6 gigabytes used of 256. And then the next screenshot shows the system and other update. So you'll see we're about 9.5 gigabytes, or 9.44 and 9.45 gigabytes. If we take a look at the current storage, it's actually pretty good. So let's go to iPhone storage, 42.3 gigabytes. I wouldn't expect that to really change because that's actual storage on the phone. But if we go down to the bottom, it's a little bit better with other 1.05 gigabytes and 6.72 gigabytes for system. So a little bit more for system, but other is almost non-existent. So it's something that I was really pleased to see. Now, another thing to note is that supposedly this is going to fix location services when it comes to iPhone 11, 11 Pro, and 11 Pro Max with wideband technology. And wideband allows me to actually locate the device by pointing it at something when you go to AirDrop or something like that. So if you have a file you want to AirDrop, you can just point it at a Mac or a different iPhone, and that will allow it to select it. Well, a lot of the time, this notification arrow shows you that you're actually using location services, and there was no way to turn it off because Apple wasn't allowing you to turn off the wideband technology in the newer phones. Now, I don't know if they've fixed it 100%, but I did test it. And if you go into your settings and go to privacy, then go to location services and turn it off altogether, the actual arrow will disappear. Now, it does do that on some of the previous versions, but for a lot of people, it wouldn't go away on the newer devices. So try it out for yourself and let me know in the comments below if you think they fixed it, although they have said nothing about it in the notes. And then another thing they haven't mentioned that it will take a little bit to know for sure if it's fixed is screen time. There were ways to bypass this and ways around it, and they may have patched it in this update. And we'll have to really wait until some people test it to make sure, but it seems like they probably are just pushing bug fixes and performance fixes with this particular update. Now, speaking of performance, I did run a Geekbench. We'll talk about that in a little bit. And performance on this has been really good. In fact, I was trying it on some of the older devices, the iPhone SE, for example. I was just messing around with Minecraft, and it seems to be okay. I wouldn't say it's phenomenal as far as what it was before, but it resumes nice and quick. Frame rates seem to be pretty good. And if you go out of this and then go into settings, for example, it just seems to be nice and smooth overall. And the same is true on the iPhone XR that I have here. So some of you were asking to see this device in more videos. So again, the same thing holds true, nice and fast. When you swipe between apps or open a new app such as music, it's just nice and fast. Now, I think they improve performance, and the Geekbench numbers definitely show that. But also with the iPad gets nothing new as far as what we can see. So the exact same things are going to hold true across iOS and iPadOS, but there's just nothing we can physically see. So unfortunately, unless there's really minute pixel level changes, we're not seeing anything there. Now, as far as battery life is concerned, when I did a poll and then a follow-up video on iOS 13.3, about 50% of the people said they had good battery life and 50% said it was terrible. So Apple obviously needs to do some work as far as managing that. And my battery has been okay. You'll see today it's 3 hours and 5 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 32 minutes of screen off time. That was with iOS 13.3. But to know how iOS 13.3.1 will be, will take a few days. It takes a few days to know what that's going to be like overall. But right now I have 70% of my battery life left and I've got over 3 hours of usage with a lot of screen off time as well. So it's actually pretty good. So if you actually multiply that out throughout the day, we're still getting around the 10 to 12 hours of screen on time mark. So it's pretty good there. Again, I'll be doing a follow-up and we'll see how it is after a few days. Now, as far as Geekbench scores are concerned, let's talk about those for a moment. Now I'm using Geekbench 5, so the numbers are a little bit lower than you're used to seeing if you're coming from Geekbench 4. They kind of reset everything if you're not familiar with that. But on the iPhone 11 Pro Max, I scored 1,325 for single core, 3,452 for multi-core. When it comes to the history, the scores are actually a little bit higher than we had before when it comes to multi-core, but they're a little bit lower for single core. So no significant changes there. I wouldn't really expect any major performance differences on the new ones, but let's take a look at all of these devices so you can see what yours is like if you have a device that's got a similar CPU in it. On the left, I have the iPad Air 2. Then I have the iPhone SE, then the iPhone XR, and then the iPhone 11 Pro Max. So this will just give you a general idea of what your scores could be overall. If they're anywhere near this, that's a good sign. Now, when it comes to Apple's release schedule, it's going to be a little bit different for a while because next week is Christmas. And because of the holidays, I wouldn't expect Apple to push out a release until maybe the 6th or so. It's possible they could sneak one in next week, but I highly doubt it. Most people at Apple will be on vacation, so Beta 1 will carry us probably until the new year, and then maybe next year we'll see iOS 13.4 with some little bits of changes or feature adds and things like that. And then in June, we'll see iOS 14. So unless Apple changes this up this year, I'm expecting to see that in that order. So hopefully we'll see some new features with 13.4. I wouldn't hold my breath for any of those, but we'll probably see some changes as far as all of that goes. Now, iOS 13.3 has been much better for me personally than previous versions of iOS 13. That's not always the case for some of you, but I do community polls to see how things are for you. And I actually have one running right now. So if you go to my channel and then you tap on community at the top, there's a community poll asking about how iOS 13 is after 90 days. So if you haven't participated in this yet, go ahead and check it out. I'll be doing a video on some of these things a little bit later, but I often do polls just to see how these are going for you. And it goes into a little bit more detail and I read your comments as well. So if you're interested in that, please go ahead and check it out. And then other than that, there's not much else to talk about. I expect a new beta in a few weeks. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.